Hello and welcome to Scottish Ancestral Records. Now, due to the very heavy rain, I'm afraid Ken's episode for Census Records will be at the beginning of February. However, Ken and I were having a chat, and it's quite important to us that, albeit we're speaking about essentially bits of paper, we're speaking about census records, we're talking about birth certificates, we're talking about death certificates, but it's very important to us to speak about the people, because that's what, certainly to myself, family research and ancestry is all about. It is a very emotional experience, because you're not just looking at an ancestor, and you know, these are people that are part of your bloodline. They're part of your family. They're part of your makeup. So I'd like to tell you the story of Ronald and George Anderson. I've spoken previously about the effect my granddad Pete had on me with regards to ancestry. My granddad Pete would tell me these family stories. I would go away and find the relevant bit of paper, and I'd come back, and for him it would be quite delightful. And I would love seeing the expression on his face that the story he told me was actually kind of true or partly true. And as is with family research, it's sometimes some of the bits that make up the whole. Now, my granddad had a younger brother called Ronald, who unfortunately passed away at a year, just over a year and a half years old. And he passed away in 1943 through congestive heart failure. And it was, my granddad would sometimes say to me, "Yeah, I need to find out who the wee boy is. He's buried at the Dysart Cemetery." He would mention it. He would mention it once in a while. He'd say, I want to see where the wee boy is. I want to find out who the wee boy is." Always called Ronald the wee boy. And for some reason in my head, I always got a picture of this blue-eyed, my granddad had blue eyes, blonde-haired, angelic-looking child. I started looking in Dysart Cemetery for Ronald. Now, we had a map. My granddad had the original map with a dip where the original grave was marked. But as people from Fife will be aware, Dysart Cemetery has increased in size greatly since 1943. We always knew that Ronald was with his grandparents. So I'm searching Dysart Cemetery, and this goes on for a year and a half, I would say. Didn't do it all the time, but I would go up and spend an hour walking around the gravestones, and you know, I'm looking for a pauper's grave essentially. And what I find is a crypt, a plot of land that was bought. And I would phone my dad, I'd phone my granddad up and say, "I'm here," da, 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 and it, like, it's at the back, it's right at the back. So eventually, after months and months of trying, I went up one Sunday morning and searched the new bit towards the road, and I'm walking up, and there they are. There he is. There's Ronald. But I'll be quite honest, I burst into tears. I burst into tears because I'd been looking for this wee laddie for a year and a half. It seemed to me my granddad had been looking for him most of his life. So I took a video. My granddad, even before he passed away, was great in his legs. So I took a video of the cemetery, so I knew where it goes, so I knew where it was. I took pictures. There was a lovely verse on the headstones. It was almost like an arch reaching up to the sky. And it was a real momentous and emotional occasion finding this gravestone. I go to visit my granddad and I tell him I found the wee boy, and his face is just, the expression in his face is something I'll remember all my days. So now, I don't think he ever made it down to see where Ronald was, but he saw the video and he knew he was there. And then that was enough for us. So that was really good. And ever since and at Christmas time, Ronald, you know, it was a year and a half when he died, and it occurred to me that maybe a lot of people hadn't had the chance to go down and see him. So every year at Christmas, my nephew George, who has a massive collection of cars, will give me a car to give to Ronald. So last year he got a fire engine truck, and at Christmas time I left it for him. My dad jokes that it probably was there for about half an hour before it got taken away. But I like to think that Ronald knows it was there, and I also like to think that perhaps this toy has reached a child who might not be able to have it otherwise. So that's who Ronald. That's who Ronald. Year and a half. Also, on the same gravestone is a George Anderson. Now, George Anderson was born in 1856 in Dysart. His mum was Margaret Anderson, née Mitchell, and his dad was George Anderson. And the gravestone says he died in New South Wales, Australia. Ex-police researcher, bloodhound. I'm very interested in how he's got there. What's his story? So I end up trying to find it during my ancestry. So I do a little bit of digging online. Aren't able to find it. Can't find anything on Scotland's people. I take one of my monthly trips to the Scottish Genealogy Society. And I walk around and there's a book on Fife Death, who dies at the cemetery. So I open up page and I find them. I find them. George Anderson, ploughman, son of the late George Anderson, weaver, Dysart. For a long number of years acted as a hostler, that's a groomsman, at the Royal Dysart Hotel. Emigrated to Australia in 1884 and died aged 40 in a place called Pretty Gully, Australia, New South Wales. So I was immediately very curious, being a groomsman working for a lot of years at the Royal Dysart Hotel, what made him get up and decide to take what I would imagine would be a very arduous, difficult journey to New South Wales. What made it, was it work? Was it, I can only admire the guts of that decision. Wow, what bravery. I managed to find a little bit of detail. There was an advert that was published in a New South Wales newspaper. Notice is hereby given the rule of court to administer the estate of the above named deceased. George Anderson, minor, Pretty Gully. On the 16th day of April 1894. So the government has gone and taken his estate essentially. And I thought, minor? What sort of minor was he? So I had a look. And Pretty Gully in the 1890s was a haven for gold miners. Our George had got on a boat for months to follow a dream of finding gold in Australia. Wow, that's pretty amazing, isn't it? These stories of ancestry and these people on bits of paper, they come alive when you find their story. I don't think I'm quite done with this. I want to find out what happened to him. Was he injured? You know, did he fall on hard times and wasn't able to feed himself? I want to find out a little bit more about the circumstances in which he passed away. But I must admit, it was pretty cool. Because I had to phone my mum up and say, oh, by the way, I found George Anderson down you. And she's like, oh, right, yeah. And I said, he was Indiana Jones. And she's like, what do you mean? I says, well, he's a gold miner. They went to find treasure. And she's like, that's amazing. And I think the best bit out of all of it is I think my granddad would have really, really liked this story. My granddad passed away at the beginning of GR. Still miss him every single day, and I like to think that he's looking down on me, finding all this information, and is getting a right hoot out of it. This is for the Andersons. This is for Ronald, George Anderson, and the departed, lovely, smart, lovable rogue granddad, Peter Anderson. So we'll be back in a few weeks to talk about census records. But in the meantime, I might share a few more stories with regards to family history. If you're out there and want to share your family stories, please get in contact. I'd love to hear from you. All the best. See you soon. Take care.